Because Jonas is a pedophile. He's only attracted to female children between the ages of 6 and 12 years. But since he's aware of the consequences for the children, he has never given in to his sexual drive.
Hey, thanks for watching. Before we start, if you have not subscribed, do it now so you and me, we can spread the message. At the end of the video, please like and share so this video would reach many more people, so together we will educate others. Thank you.
Let me tell you about Jonas. Jonas is 19 years old. He studies law in Munich. In his spare time, he likes to play soccer. Jonas has a secret which he thinks he cannot share with anyone, not even with his best friend or with his parents.
We're gonna stop right here for a second. I love how she starts by drawing you in with a soft, low pitch, deceiving voice and very relaxed posture as she continues to tell us a story. She wants us to resonate with the character in the story.
He's just too afraid of anger, rejection, and repulsion. Jonas knows that he has to suppress his sexual drive for his entire life. And he also knows that there will never be a loving and fulfilling partnership that he can enter.
And as she continues, she uses words like he's too afraid of anger, rejection, and repulsion, as we should feel sorry for the character in the story. She chooses a certain tone to draw us in and keep us on suspense by opening our mind for a possibility that we might be wrong or we should look from an opposite view.
Because Jonas is a pedophile. He's only attracted to female children between the ages of 6 and 12 years. But since he's aware of the consequences for the children, he has never given in to his sexual drive.
It's interesting that most pedophiles are interested in girls that have not hit maturity level. So what happens when she becomes older? His needs don't just go away, but rather expand for another young girl. And this process never stops. It continues to escalate and grow as his inclination does not suddenly stop. If animals taste human blood, they are prone to switch and hunt for more. So pedophilia is not orientation, it's a disease or a virus that needs to be stopped and expunged. It's pretty much saying to all people with a psychopath thinking, hey, raping women and children is okay, since you have natural tendency towards this direction or you're inclined this way. Or to killers, hey, you have urges to murder someone? Why not? Have at it.
Therefore, pedophilia is not an irrelevant phenomenon we can't simply ignore. Chances every one of you knows at least one pedophile are higher than that you don't know anyone.
Well, number one, people, I hope we never come to this. That's just plain disgusting. I know in some cultures, girls were married off at very young age. For instance, Aisha was married at 9 years old of age and she was a mother of a Muhammad. But that was long time ago. I don't know if you know this in United States, and it might even shock you, with a parent consent in Massachusetts, you can marry a girl at 12 years old. And also in New Hampshire at 13 of age. I don't know how perverse or ignorant you have to be to pass such legislation, and who would dare to give their daughter at such age? Just unspeakable.
We haven't found out yet why pedophilia occurs.
Well, you're wrong. I can answer that. And there's many ways you can become a pedophile. And one of them is very simple. But we have to understand one thing. Our actions are not derived from just doing wrongful act or committing a crime unless you are under hypnosis or some other method. But rather, every thought that comes in our mind, we are the captains of it. We can control what we ponder on or pass on. Feelings don't just appear from nowhere and we start feeling something different. If we choose to contemplate on our thoughts on a regular basis, we give birth to a new desire. And a desire gives us a new feeling that we tend to crave. So in a nutshell, every thought can give birth to either good or bad. We are the creators. We choose what we tend to think most of.
So generally speaking, anyone could be born a pedophile.
You can't tell me I was born this way. It's impossible. Another way people tend to become is if you are the victim of pedophilia by either teacher, family friend, or someone that you know, and it passes through the heinous act, as either you think by hurting another human being this will bring justice, or you actually develop inclination and think that is okay. Then she goes on to explain pedophilia and characteristics of it, how you can still be attracted to same age or older, but your preferences would be little girls or boys. Very sick individuals. What is interesting, she points out that vast majority of all pedophiles are men, and it's 99%, and I wouldn't be surprised. In conclusion, I will include a link below, full version of the TED Talk, just so you can listen for yourself. But this is presented to you and me, so we become immune and think this is okay. Media spins their role by brainwashing us to accept them and uplift their sexual desires. You know, before 1973, it was known and said by doctors, homosexuality is a mental disorder and needs to be treated. But as time passed on, more people came out and stood their ground, fought for their rights, and we know now it is legal for homosexuals to marry and even to adopt. Rights were given to LGBTQ community, but now, if we don't protest or stand up, there will be legal pedophilia, and who knows, probably bestiality as well. As we give more room for such kind of people, we will suffer serious consequences. Being as a father, I cannot stand by and just watch what's going on and not say something. I'm disgusted to hear such filth and nonsense. Please help me spread this message and make people aware of what's going on. If you haven't subscribed in the beginning, please do it now so you and me can spread the word. Don't forget to like and share. I'm counting on you. Thanks. Till next time.